But there's people are waiting for the collaboration between Mahesh Bhatt and Alia Bhatt. When can we see that happen?
This is not a conference about about that. And I will only reveal my card. I've learned one thing from Alia Bhatt, is that if I get the gene from him about not having any barriers and no filter, especially with the media, Alia has learned that to hold your cards close to your chest is more profitable with the media, which is why on a certain level she's commercially more successful than me, because when I was an actor, I was out there and India and the world and the industry was not ready for my candidness. So she's taught me that the world does not deserve your truth all the time. But like I said, I've got his blood coursing through my veins in more ways than one. And I am going to take a tip from my younger sister and keep my cards close to my chest. Cheers. In this case. And all news about Alia Bhatt, Mahesh Bhatt, Pooja Bhatt and all the Bhatt's collaboration
and what
will happen at a future date.
Will happen.
No, but sir, but social media is a buzz with...
Social media must be a buzz.
One second. With Sadak 2 happening, it's a great moment for the Bhatt family as well as for all the fans around. Kuch uske bare mein.
Sadak 2 is happening.
What is it happening?
It is happening.
When
and how and with who is happening?
But, my question is, will you return back to direction?
Hello? Is it happening?
It is happening.
I don't know.
It is happening.
But sir, a word on Sadak.
No, I think we have very clearly said that Sadak is a franchise which flowered on its own after a long time. We have a brilliant script which has been put together by a writer from my friend from Bengal, Churita, and me. Now, you will have to wait with your held breath for the proper announcement, because that is the prerogative of my brother Mukesh Bhatt.
Yes. The production house needs to announce the details of it. But all I can confirm is that it is indeed happening. And I must also say, it was Sanjay Dutt who initiated it.
Who did it?
He was the one who came to me and he said, why are we not making Sadak 2? And I said, it's not my property. Aajkal to property bulate hai na film ko. So I said, it's not my property, it's Mukesh Bhatt's property. And he said, talk to Bhatt Saab, and I went to them and I said, look, Sanjay Dutt really has this urge and desire to kind of give this light. So do you think there's any possibility?
And rest of
the and they have a connection that I don't think anybody has.
Sanju and me are soulmates.
I mean, whether it's Naam, whether it's Sadak Part 1, and you know, it's just the response that he evokes in him and vice versa that actually drew this. And I think what we're really looking forward to, I was spoiled because I had the best of Mahesh Bhatt. And I had no desire to really act when he quit direction. But I think that what we're getting through this, and when I see Surita and him working on it, we're going to be going back to the times in the 90s where filmmaking was more organic and the learning was greater in between shots, where it's not these PR-generated, smoothened times without the rough edges. And what we're looking forward to is the film for sure, but we're looking forward to being there on set and feeling like we felt back in the day, because that's really contributed to the kind of people that we are today. You know, working with him was not about what happened in front of the camera, but what happened between the shots.
You want him to return to direction with Sadak 2?
Well, we don't know anything about anything. I mean,
my question is, where did he ever go to come back? He's been here all throughout.
All we are saying that Churita and me have finished a brilliant script, and we will not be in a position to speak more. No comments has not been my way of life, but I think it is the right of the production
house. The privilege of the production house as well.
Because they are, my brother is in partnership.
No, it's his baby. It's Mukesh Bhatt's baby in many ways.
It is his right to go out there and decide that time and the manner in which he chooses to reveal.
And we would like to see you all again and give you all a cup of tea.
Meanwhile, bye-bye, nice meeting you, and play basketball.
केरला के जो फ्लड
आई है उसमें यूएई ने 700 करोड़ भाई केरला के फ्लड के बारे में पूरा हिंदुस्तान एक होकर रिस्पॉन्ड कर रहा है. ये एक बहुत ही मुबारक निशानी है और हमने सब अपने अपने तरीके से जो हमारा योगदान हो सकता था हमने किया है. और ये सिर्फ एक इस हफ्ते का काम नहीं रहेगा, ये कंसिस्टेंटली वहाँ पर हमको अपनी नज़र बनाए रखनी पड़ेगी, क्योंकि ये ऐसे जब हादसे होते हैं, ऐसे जो कैटास्ट्रोफीज होती हैं, उसको उससे निकलने के लिए समाज को बहुत वक्त लगता है. और जैसे जिस्म का एक हिस्सा आपका उसको घाव लग जाए तो पूरे जिस्म का कर्तव्य होता है कि उसको हील करें. तो वैसे ही हमको एज अ नेशन विल हैव टू गिव एवरीथिंग टू केरला एंड सी इट कम्स आउट फ्रॉम दिस डार्कनेस.
थैंक यू सर.
इसके अलावा पाकिस्तान के पीएम इमरान खान ने भी कहा है कि हम मदद करेंगे, तो कैसे रिलेशनशिप और अच्छे होंगे इंडिया पाकिस्तान के, आपको लगता है?
देखो भैया, तो ये इंसान ने आपके दुख दर्द में शामिल होकर जताया है कि वो आपके दर्द से जुड़ना चाहता है, ऐसे में हमको उनका हाथ थामना चाहिए, क्योंकि इस पृथ्वी पर हम जितना भी चाहें लकीरें खींच लें, कम से कम ये इंसान होने का एहसास जब तक हमको बांध कर रखेगा तब तक ही हम सुरक्षित रहेंगे।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल।
यूएई ने 700 करोड़ देने का जो अनाउंसमेंट किया, लेकिन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने उसे एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया अभी तक, तो क्या
ये सुना इस पर अजीब सा एक विरोध चल रहा है, किसी ने कहा है कि किया है, कोई कह रहा है नहीं किया है, ये तो आप लोग जान सकते हैं, आप ही हमको बताएंगे, क्योंकि आज की तारीख में रियल न्यूज़, फेक न्यूज़, प्लांटेड न्यूज़, मोटिवेटेड न्यूज़ के बीच में हम जो सीधे साधे लोग
हैं, what you see is not what you get most of the time।
तो ये हाथी के दांत दिखाने के और खाने के, और अब हमारे पास इतना वक्त कहाँ है कि बेटी की नौकरी करें और पेपर लगाएं।
बास्केटबॉल।
Lastly, we don't get you often. Social media is abuzz with the marriage of Alia. You've been a person who speaks his heart out.
I think you should be asking Alia about her personal life, not us.
I have never spoken about my children's private life. They are adults. It is their prerogative. I would never demean them, belittle them, and talk about that. That's their right. If they choose to talk about it,
or not choose to talk about it,
or they choose to be silent, it's their affair. I respect them for what they do with their life.
I think that when I began my journey with Rohit and with the league and with 3BL, if you ask me what do I know on a scale of 0 to 10 about basketball, the answer was an resounding, honest zero. But I think when I watched my first round in Noida, and of course my team won, and I got a taste of blood, and I got a taste of how exciting and how thrilling the entire game and the format is. What I loved about it was the fact that initially I wondered why he was hosting it at a mall as opposed to in a stadium. But then I understood that he's doing that because he wants to make the game and the sport accessible to people. And I think that even when you look at the movies, to draw people into a theater today is a nightmare. People want to see a movie on their phone, they want to see it on their TV, they want to see it at their time. And here was somebody coming in and saying, hey, we'll bring the sport to you, you don't have to come to us. So I admired that, and that there's a learning there for us as filmmakers as well. My team, I fell absolutely in love with. And I remember telling them after the first round that, hey, you know what, now you've stuck with me, but I'm going to follow you everywhere. And then he took it to very unusual places. He went to the Northeast, he went to Aizawl, where the actual screaming basketball fans actually are. Yes, and I just wish that more people came out in other cities as well. But I think I experienced Kolkata with you, yeah, and Noida, and now Bangalore. And now I'm hoping Mumbai is as riveting. But I think that also you get a feeling of the topography and the model and the basic heat and temperature of your country, because from every state to state, the fans differ, yes, the attitudes differ, yes, the response differs. So it's a great way to re-look at your very own people through a different perspective, and that is basketball. So for me as a filmmaker, this gives me the chance to leave my myopic world of entertainment, come out into a completely different field, understand and learn how little I know about this. So it humbles me, it humiliates me to understand that, hey, there's so much more that you don't know about. And an athlete and a filmmaker, or an athlete and actor, is not different, because we have to go out there and we have to perform with our entire beings. And we fall and we fail and we pick ourselves up and we start all over again. So there are a lot of similarities that I see in both strains. And boss, it's a conviction business. I think the world lacks believers, not talent. So he is one such believer because he loves basketball. His intent is pure. And I'm somebody who picks up vibes and intent. And I think it was his intent was something that was undeniable, which is why I got involved in more ways than just merely being a team owner.
Right.
And I'm like, my commitment is complete and full to what he's trying to achieve in India with this league. And I think it's my moral duty to help him achieve that dream, you know, because it's all of our dreams somewhere. When we see our very own shine in the world arena, I think that we all somewhere gloat about it. So why not help the process?
Right. Rohit, how has your journey been? You have Pooja, you have Bhatt.
My journey for 3BL this year so far has been great. We had a hurdle every single state, and you won't believe every single state had a different issues.
It's like filmmaking, firefighting.
We get to experience entire India, north, south, east, west. We met a lot of different kind of fans. We never thought Calcutta would be a place where we'll get a lot of engagement. One of the biggest engagement we got was in Chennai. During the match of World Cup, Azol people came. There was about 5,000 people turned out in Azol round in the middle of the World Cup. And believe me when I say this, Mizoram and the Azol is a football city and a football state. They loved the story. They left that opportunity of watching, and then they came to watch us live. And game has been brought me to this new. I mean, you know, every single state is so new that, you know, every time we're experiencing a new
crowd. Yeah, the new learning each time.
New learning, new people. And this time, Mahesh is also, giving us a warm words. It means a lot for us in terms of our basketballers and for the basketball community.
Right. You all want to call the public to come and watch the show if you're... Want to say that to the camera.
Yes, tomorrow 2 p.m. Phoenix, Market City, Kurla. Do come there. You will see something which you have never seen before. You'll see the different kind of basketball. This is a basketball and entertainment, and the kind of entertainment you will never be able to experience. And watching it live and watching on the ground is 100x different. Mark my word, you'll have a great day.
And I will be there, so please come and watch. No, but the truth is that, yes, like Rohit says, that it's not only basketball. There's a whole lot of entertainment because the game itself is very thrilling, very entertaining. And it's happening in our backyard, Mumbai. Yep. And Mumbai is known for its dildar spirit, of its generosity, of welcoming people from every walk of life with open arms. So I would expect my town, my city, to come out there and show my team and the entire league a lot of love. So chalo Mumbai, meri jaan. Ajao to Phoenix Market City tomorrow and day after from 2 to 7 and cheer the entire league on.
Thank you.
Thank you.